Hey everyone, it's Justin again. A long time ago, we learned how to find the slope of a line. However, lately we've been experiencing more and more non-linear graphs that don't have a set slope. For this lesson, we're going to be learning about a version of slope that works with non-linear functions, average rate of change. We already know how to find the slope of a line. We choose two points on the line, find the rise and the run, and put them in a fraction, rise over run. This slope applies anywhere on the line, no matter what points we choose. If we instead use these two points, the rise and the run would still be the same. Even if we choose two points far apart, the rise over run fraction reduces to the same thing. This works for any linear function. But what about a non-linear function? We could choose two points and find the rise over run, but does this slope of -3 apply to the whole graph? Clearly not. If we use these two points, the slope would be 0. These two points give a slope of 3, and these two tell us the slope is 1. We wouldn't say this is the slope of the graph, because it isn't the same for the whole graph. Instead, we would call it the average rate of change on each interval. On the interval from -3 to -2, the average rate of change is -3. From -2 to 0, the average rate of change is 0. From 0 to -1, it's 3. And from -2 to 1, it's 1. Average rate of change is a way to measure how quickly something changed on average over the course of an interval. It's incredibly useful in many different jobs and contexts, but we'll talk more about that in the next video. For now, let's practice calculating average rates of change. What is the average rate of change on the interval from 0 to 4 on this function? To figure that out, we find the point where the input is 0 and the point where the input is 4, then find the slope between those two points. Rise 2, run 4. So the average rate of change is 2 over 4, or 1/2. This isn't a perfect estimation. After all, we can see that at one point the graph was going down, not up. What the average rate of change means is that after all the ups and downs from one point to the other, the output increased by an average of 0.5 units for every 1 unit the input went up. Average rate of change is a good way of estimating patterns, but it tends to work best on intervals that only increase or decrease. For instance, if we find the average rate of change on this decreasing interval from 1 to 3, we get -1. If we connect the endpoints with a line, the slope of that line very closely approximates the function. Much better than on the interval from 0 to 4. We can also find the average rate of change with just a table of points. Average rate of change uses the same formula as slope. Rise over run, change in y over change in x, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. It's all the same. So to find the average rate of change, we locate the endpoints of the interval, which are -1 and 3 in this example, then use the slope formula with those two points. 2 minus -5 over 3 minus -1 is equal to 7 over 4. So the average rate of change on the interval from -1 to 3 is 7 over 4. But remember, average rate of change only applies to that specific interval. So if we change the interval, the rate of change will be different. For the interval from 0 to 1, we use the slope formula to find that the average rate of change is -5, which is much different from the interval from -1 to 3. Slope of a line is the same for all points, but never assume the same average rate of change for a function will be the same for multiple intervals. Average rate of change just seems like a less accurate version of slope. Why would we want that? Well, in the next video, we're going to actually apply average rate of change with real-world contexts so you'll understand and appreciate just how useful average rate of change can truly be. See you then!